Hi children, good morning everyone. Welcome to my class. Yesterday class in we all discussed about the sources of history. Today I continue the class about the sources of history. See children, here role of sources to construct the history. The sources of history can be classified into two groups. Yesterday I told sources of history was classified into two groups. First one is literary sources, second one is archaeological sources. See here, chart is there, sources of history. Sources of history divided into two groups. One is literary sources, another one is archaeological sources. Understood?
These are all inscriptions. This is monuments. This is pieces of words and other artifacts are also remaining about the archaeological evidence. Understand? The remains that have been buried in the earth are removed through the excavation. The historical evidences include coins, inscriptions, monuments, pieces of forts and other artifacts. Understand? Next, last point in this same chapter, introduction to history. That in last chapter, last point, India has introduced by Europeans. What? India has introduced by Europeans. See, Indians had the knowledge of history in the form of Puranas and myths from ancient times. It means what? Indians had a knowledge of the history through the Puranas and myths from ancient period or ancient times. But this was different. But this was totally different from the European model of constructing history. Among the Europeans who arrived in India in 16th century were Jesuit priests. They undertook a systematic study to understand the lifestyle of Indians. Once again, among the Europeans who arrived in India in 16th century, they visited to India because of to spread the Christian religion all over the country. So they were visited to India or arrived to India. In 16th century were Jesuit priests. Jesuit means what? The member of the Society of Jesus were called Jesuit. Jesuit means what? The member of the Society of Jesus were called Jesuit. Jesuit priests, they undertook a systematic study to understand the lifestyle of Indians. He came to India. That time he settled in Agra and he translated Sanskrit grammar into Latin language about 350 century or years ago. Understand? Enrich Roth, who was settled in Agra, and he translated Sanskrit grammar into Latin language about 350 years ago. A century later, Father Curadas identified that there are many similarities between Sanskrit and European languages. European languages means what? Latin language belongs to ancient language of Europeans. Sanskrit language is ancient language of Indians. Understand? A century later, Father Curadas identified that there are many similarities between Sanskrit language and European language. Understand? The British officers tried to understand the history, traditions, customs, values, beliefs and law of Indians to strengthen their trade relationship. See, the British officers, 1947, before our country is ruled by British, that time the British officers tried to understand the history, Indian history, Indian tradition, Indian customs, Indians values, Indians beliefs and Indians laws of Indians to strengthen their trade relationship. Some administrators were attracted towards Indian literature.
another great literary work was translated to English when some British administrative officer attracted to our culture and our literature. That time they are translated the books Manuskriti, Bhagavad Gita and other great literary work were translated to English language. Sir William Jones, very important. Sir William Jones contributed immensely to the study of Indology. What is the meaning of Indology? Indology means the study of Indian culture and history is called Indology. Sir William Jones contributed immensely to the study of Indology. He came to India as a judge of Supreme Court in Bengal. It means what? Sir William Jones came to India as a judge of Supreme Court in Bengal. Understand? And established the Asiatic Society in 1784 century at Calcutta. Understand? It means Sir William Jones established the Asiatic Society in 1784 century at Calcutta, present Kolkata. Understand? Sir William Jones, who was multilingual expert. Multilingual means they were expert more than one language. It is called multilingual expert. Translated the great works like Gita, Govinda, text of Madhava, Dharma Shastra and Kalidasa's Shakuntala from Sanskrit to English language. See here, picture is there. He was the Sir William Jones. He translated the which books? Gita, Govinda, Madhava Dharma Shastra and Kalidasa's Shakuntala from Sanskrit language to English language. Understand? Sir William Jones translated the Gita Govinda, Madhava Dharma Shastra and Kalidasa's Shakuntala in which language? See, English language. Another prominent means important Orientalist and Indologist was Max Müller. Another prominent Orientalist and Indologist was Max Müller. He was a German scholar. Who was Max Müller? Max Müller was a German scholar. Who wrote an English work, Sealed Book of East, in 50 volumes? Understand? It means other prominent Orientalist and Indologist was Max Müller. He was a German scholar who wrote an English work, Sealed Book of the East, in 50 volumes. James Smith, a historian from Scotland. James Smith, see here picture is there. He was James Smith. James Smith, a historian from Scotland. He was a historian from which country? Scotland. Wrote History of India in 6 volumes, but these scholars never visited to India. Understand? But these scholars never visited to India. They were staying in their own native place, but they are interested to study about Indian history and Indian culture. Next, Abbé Dubois. Abbé Dubois, a French missionary. Who was Abbé Dubois? Abbé Dubois, a French missionary, arrived and settled at Ganjam near Srirangapatna. He lived as a sage by adopting the local culture and customs. Very important. Write a short note about the Abbé Dubois. That time you have to remember all points about the Abbé Dubois. Abbé Dubois. Ganja near Sri Lanka Patana he lived as a sage by adopting the local culture and customs. He was the Obed Du Bois. He was called Dattaswami. He was called what? Dattaswami by the local people. Local people were called to Obed Du Bois what? Dattaswami. He wrote Hindu manners, customs and ceremonies. He wrote Hindu manners, customs and ceremonies. Who? Obed Du Bois. He has presented Indian customs, values, thoughts, festivals and Varnashrama system in his work. He has presented Indian customs, values, thoughts, festivals and Varnashrama system in his work. Apart from these, Epping Stone, Close Brook and Jean Bomb, Elot and Dawson had introduced the different stages of Indian history. Understand? Next, Francis Buchanan, Cole, Wilkes and MacJay, Biggert Rice, Fleet and other European scholars have successfully recorded and preserved the inscriptions, manuscripts and other text mines and contemporary events for the reconstruction of Karnataka history. Thus, Europeans have been successful in introducing a novel way of understanding and constructing history to the Indians. This way, they have provided Indians a new process of thinking and a new present perspective to construct history. Once again, thus Europeans have been successful in introducing a novel way of understanding and constructing history to the Indians. In this way, they have provided Indians a new process of thinking and a new perspective to construct history. What does oral literature include? See, question and answer. What does oral literature include? Answer, oral literature comprises of folk songs, stories, ballads, myths and legends. Understand? Question number 2. What are archaeological sources? What are archaeological sources? Answer, the physical remains or ruins of the things used or the constructed structures in the past are archaeological sources. Note down these questions. Summary about the first chapter, Introduction to History. The systematic presentation of past events is called history. You already know that one in first class. What is the meaning of history or meaning of history? What? The systematic presentation of past events is called history. Herodotus of Greece is considered as the father of history. Who is father of history? Herodotus of Greece is considered as the father of history. Next, the one who constructed history is an historian. Who were historian? The one who construct history is an historian. They use historical evidences to be particular and analytic about history. The sources of history can be classified into two groups. One is literary sources, another one is archaeological sources. Historically speaking, literature means the written or orally conveyed information.
There are two kinds in this. One is written literature, another one is oral literature. The physical remains are means of the things used or the constructed structures in the past are archaeological sources. What is the meaning of archaeological sources mean? How to write this answer? The physical remains are means of the things used or the constructed structures in the past are called archaeological sources. Some interesting trivia for you. Ajanta and Ellora caves are considered to be one of the most important archaeological sites in India. Sites means place in India. The rocks cut caves containing carvings of the finest example of Indian paintings and sculptures. Second, one of the most important archaeological sites in India for the Buddhist Bodh Gaya is a village in the state of Bihar. It was here under the Bodhi tree that Gautama Buddha attained enlightenment. This is the first chapter, introduction to history. Okay children, are you understood this lesson?